You know, it's the holidays. Everyone's running around town with so many responsibilities, dealing with families. It can be an emotional roller coaster. But don't worry, Castle Medical Center is here to help. And I'm joined by Dr. Dennis Melian. And doctor, thank you so much for joining us here. And I got to ask, I mean, do people get sad and depressed during the holiday season, sir?
Yeah, unfortunately, it's a time that we're supposed to be happy, supposed to be jolly, but there are many of us who really feel sad and bad about this time of the year.
Yeah, and why is that? Again, it's the holidays, but, I mean, why do you think that, is it the responsibilities, the everything you're dealing with? Why does it, especially during the holiday season?
Oh, I'm sure there's many, many different reasons. It usually has to do with expectations, experiences that people have had. You know, we all come from different backgrounds. Sometimes we've had happy childhood Christmas times. Sometimes very sad, different times. And sometimes people have been lost in the family. We think of Christmas as family time, but not all families are intact. Not all families have had good times together. So there's lots of reasons from past experiences, past pains, past arguments that make it difficult for folks. The expectation that sometimes the commercial world presents to us that Christmas is supposed to be a really fun, happy, good giving time doesn't fit for a lot of people.
No, you're so right, sir. We're overloaded with the music, the commercials. I mean, everyone's jolly, but, you know, I'm glad you point that, sir. You know, it's managing the expectations. I grew up in a family that Christmas was very different. We were overseas. We moved a lot. Mm-hmm. So I didn't have a Christmas tree until I was 11 years old. Mm-hmm. And now having a family and melding other traditions, it's difficult. It's new for me, to tell you the truth.
It's a challenge in how to sort of fit what the stereotype Christmas is, and maybe we haven't had that. Sometimes, like here in Hawaii, we're a long way from family, and that's sort of more painful than fun. We might maybe can't afford to travel there, be with them, and so lots of reasons. Sometimes deaths of significant family members come up more at this time.
Yeah.
So probably nearly half of us see Christmas as sad or bad rather than happy and good.
And knowing all those things, what is the best way going into the holiday season? You know, you're talking about the expectations. Is it good to manage it? What are some tips we should kind of keep in mind, sir?
Yeah, I think sometimes we just let Christmas descend upon us and we haven't planned or thought about it, and then it becomes overwhelming. It's probably good if we can give it some thought way before Christmas. This is still not too late to be thinking, what might I do this Christmas that would be good? Good for me, good for my family or whatever. And it doesn't have to be the traditional things. It has to be things that make sense for us today. And a lot of that is not so much thinking about how am I going to enjoy Christmas, but maybe how can others enjoy Christmas that I can do something to contribute.
Wow.
I think that makes a real big difference. If it's, you know, sometimes we think of Christmas as a time getting gifts. Maybe we'd be thinking about giving gifts and thinking of folks who are less fortunate than us, and really seeing what we might do to serve others during this time of the year.
Doctor, that's such a great point. Now, you know, you talk about families coming together, though, and say during a family thing or family time, if there's a family member out there that may notice a friend or a loved one maybe a little bit down, maybe, is there words of advice if I'm knowing someone, an uncle, you know, he doesn't look so happy this Christmas, should I do something? Should I approach him? What would be the best thing to do, sir?
Yeah, I think it is that, to see it for one thing. Sometimes we're so much into ourselves, we don't see the pain of even family members or others around us. So I think to see it and then to be understanding of what that person might be going through, try to relate to that. And often it's just a matter of spending time, being supportive, having conversation, inviting them over for a meal, going for a walk together, doing things that give him or her the opportunity to share some of the pain they might be going through.
Yeah.
Opening up about that pain will often relieve it a lot. And if we become that avenue for that, it really can be very helpful.
You know, and I love what you're saying, Ter. Castle's so great. If there's somebody out there, they're feeling these things. I mean, you guys have programs and people willing, if they need help, if family members aren't there, they can get in touch with you guys,
right? Absolutely.
What would be the best thing?
There's always somebody available if anyone calls in, we can be responsive on the phone. We can be responsive if they come into our crisis emergency department. Mm-hmm. We have counselors, doctors who are available to chat, to respond, to support. Not always to be in the hospital, but just to give some support and encouragement during this very difficult time of the year.
Doctor, thank you so much for coming and talking about this. The more we talk, I realize there's so many people that are affected by this. We'll have all the information. Again, Castle is there for you guys. And I like how you said, sir, don't let Christmas and these things descend upon you. Take control. Mm-hmm. Be proactive about it.
Exactly.
Thank you.
Thanks for the chance to be here.
This is some good stuff. Again, I'm already eternalizing it and keeping it in my mind again for the holiday season. Good things.
Thank you.